Hello dear children, good afternoon everyone. So once again welcome back you all to the online classes. And we know that now we are discussing the physical phenomenon, the fourth unit of your science part. And in that now we are discussing about the natural calamities, or we can also call them as natural disasters. So in the previous class we have already discussed the causes and what are the precautionary measures we have to take in such when the natural calamities or the disasters occur. So already we have discussed about the earthquakes, tsunamis and also the volcanic eruptions. So about this all we have already discussed in our previous class. And in the today's class we are going to discuss about some other natural disasters. So at the end of this class you are able to understand about the cyclones and floods and the droughts and also the role of government. So after when we learned at the end of this class, you can able to understand how the cyclones are occur and what are its effects and what are the precautionary measures we have to take, and also the floods and droughts, and in such all the natural calamities when they are occurs, so how the government will help the people. So what are the roles of the government in such natural disasters? Means when the condition is that much critical, so how the government will help the people? So about that all you will understand in this class. Okay, now we can discuss one by one. So first we can discuss about the cyclones. So these cyclones are formed when the low pressure zones are created. So how these low pressure zones are created? See, for example, when our earth is having the water on its surface, right? So when the water on the surface of the earth gets evaporated, ನೀರು ಇರ್ತೈತಲ್ಲ ಭೂಮಿ ಮೇಲೆ, ಸೊ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಇವಾಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೋದಂಗೆ ಹೋದಂಗೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅ ವಾಟರ್ ವೇಪರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಮ್ ವಿಂಡ್ಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಏರಿಯಾ ಈಸ್ ಡ್ರೈ ದ ವಿಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ವಿಂಡ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಲೋ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಝೋನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ದ ವಿಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್, means when the winds are in the high speed, okay, so they create here a low pressure zone, low pressure. So here the winds are, means the winds are flowing in this direction. So these winds are what? They are moving fastly. The fast moving winds will be there here. So when the wind speed is more, it creates a low pressure zone at the center. If wind speed high aadanga aadanga enagutte, center olaga pressure kadime aagutha hogutte. So hanga ondukond winds hanga combine aagi no, there will be the strong wind started blowing. Then these winds are very powerful and those are called as the cyclones. And these cyclones are very destructive. So what are the cyclones? Now we can say the definition of cyclone like this. So cyclones are strong and powerful winds. Cyclones are strong and powerful winds that are formed around, that are for around low pressure zones. Low pressure zones over the seas. Yes. So the cyclones are strong and powerful winds. So I said when the speed of the wind. So wind is the moving air. When the speed of the wind is high. ಯಾವಾಗ ವಿಂಡ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಇರ್ತವೋ ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ದ ಲೋ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗೋದ ಹೋಗ್ತೈತಿ ವಿಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಹೈ ಆದಂಗ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗೋದ ಹೋಗ್ತೈತಿ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಲೋ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಝೋನ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ವಿಂಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ವೆರಿ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್ ವಿಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬ್ಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ದ ಸೈಕ್ಲೋನ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಸೈಕ್ಲೋನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್ ವಿಂಡ್ಸ್ that are formed around low pressure zones over the seas and these cyclones are very common in around the Bay of Bengal yes where is the Bay of Bengal yes if it is the India so here we can see here in this place the Bay of Bengal will be there so these cyclones are common in this Bay of Bengal so means there will be commonly we can see the these cyclones in these areas and they bring heavy rains and strong surges of winds so these cyclones always it involves the heavy rains as well as the strong blowing winds so when the heavy rains and strong winds are blowing so it will be destroyed it is very destructive so strong winds means we know how much it will be destructive sometimes the trees may uproot it so that much strong winds will blow and also the houses may the roofs of the houses may run off or also the due to the heavy rain the water level increases so likewise the cyclones the when the water level increases the overflow of water takes place and then the when water is overflows it can cause the floods so likewise these cyclones are very much destructive okay and see these cyclones they are rotate the clockwise so how the clock is moving so these cyclones are in the clockwise so it will move like this in the clockwise direction and in the Atlantic and the Northern Pacific Ocean in Atlantic and Northern Pacific Ocean these are called as hurricanes now in karitivi in india we commonly call them as the cyclones but atlantic and northern pacific ocean atlantic and northern pacific ocean olaga en karitare cyclone ge hurricanes they are called them as the hurricanes and also in the northwestern pacific northwestern pacific these cyclones are called typhoons north western pacifically cyclones again karitaru typhoons ante karitaru and the atlantic and northern pacific oceans alli ukin karitaru hurricanes ante karitaru and these hurricanes and typhoons both these hurricanes and typhoons they are rotating anti clockwise so they will be rotated like this so the direction of this is anti clockwise so the cyclones are rotated in the clockwise so cyclones are rotated tori ee riti rotated clockwise so they will be rotated in anti clockwise direction so in India we call them as the cyclone and in Atlantic and Pacific Ocean they call as the hurricanes and in the northwestern pacific they call as the typhoons okay And next, the effects of cyclones. What are the effects caused by the cyclones? So here, these cyclones are destructive because we know that the cyclone is having the strong and powerful winds, and also they bring heavy rain. So when the areas are affected with the cyclones, so many people they become homeless because they destroy everything, and also many of the life, yes, many people will lost their life and property, and the wildlife also, the domestic life, you know, so they also destroy. So likewise, these are all the effects will cause due to the cyclones. And some people they will displace to another place because to the safety places they have to move. Otherwise, if they stay in that place only, so they will also affect and they may lose their life, they will lose their property. So the people in advance only they get the warnings, so that so and so date the cyclone will hit in this area, means the warnings will be come from the government, so that they will be displaced from that place to other safer places. So when these come, when these cyclones affect, even they will destruct all the, means they will collapse all the buildings and all. So this is what the destruction caused by the cyclones. And in these cases, even government also supplies some facilities with the with all the medicines and all. And also the dead bodies lying in the, means when the cyclones is affected and when it is become calm, so that then even the dead bodies also lying there, so that when the animals are dead, so they are undergo decomposition. Our collapse start occur, you know, some the harmful microorganisms will be started growing on that. Our dead bodies are lying, you know, microorganisms are grow start occur. Suppose if we live in that place, they may carry some diseases to us. So that all will be clean after all this. So debris, whatever it has left, so that all should be clean. So that is all what? These are all the effects of cyclones. And one cyclone was hit in the year of 1999 in Odisha. So that is what the cyclone 05B. Yes, it was a super cyclone. Cyclone 05B. It was hit Odisha in 1999. So it was a very massive cyclone which was hit in 25 years. So this is such a destructive that when this cyclone hits, around 1.67 million people were left homes. Means the 1.6 million people. 1.67. So 1.67 million people. So they become homeless due to this cyclone 05B. So 1.67 million people become homeless. And 19.5 million people, just they affected 19.5 million people, just they affected for some extent. So just for some extent they affected, not that much. And around 10,000 people, they have lost their life officially. So 10,000 people officially, they have lost their life. So this cyclone which was hit in Odisha in the year of 1999, that is cyclone 05B, So it was highly the massive destructions it has caused. So when it was hit, 1.67 million people become homeless, means they lost their homes, and 19.5 million people they are affected for somewhat extent, means aste illa swalpenu affect adarestu 19.5 million people, and around 10,000 people they officially they lost their life andra astu jana sattaru in that cyclone. So this is about the cyclone, and now we can discuss about the floods. So the floods, the cyclonic floods occur in the coastal areas. So mostly the floods, they are occur in the coastal areas. So but many inland areas face floods from overflowing rivers due to heavy rains. So they are, the floods are mostly occur in the coastal areas, okay, because they are near to the sea. So this occur mostly in coastal areas, mostly in coastal areas. So see, even some of the inland areas are also affected, which are not there near the coast. So those areas are also affected by the flood. The reason for that is the overflow of the water bodies. When the water become more, when the water in the water sources are rises, water bodies will be there like rivers and all. When the water level in those water bodies are increases, so the over, they will start overflowing. So when they overflow, they will they even occupy the inland areas also, so that the inland areas are also affected by the floods. And the Himalayan river Kosi, the river Kosi, it is what the Himalayan river, Himalayan river, it is called the sorrow of Bihar, sorrow of Bihar, because whenever it rains heavily, so that all the time the Kosi river overflows and it brings flood in this area. So that the Himalayan river Kosi, it is called the sorrow of Bihar. And to prevent these floods, to prevent the floods, we build the dams and also we build interconnected canal systems to prevent floods. To prevent the floods, we built the dams and interconnected canals. So dams with the interconnected canals are now built by the canal. Here in the dams, it can hold the water. It dams dams are the also, so that floods. So in the India, the floods are the most common disasters. Even we also have affected by these floods in recent days only. And the droughts. The next thing is drought. Drought means bargal. Yes, the drought. So if an area, if it receives very less rainfall or no rainfall for a long period of time, then it causes the droughts. So bargal yavaga batutte yavaga baa varsha tanaka mali aagudilla athwa kadmi mali aagutandra avaga namage enagutte bargal barutte. So when the droughts are occur, so the ground will become cracked or it will be purged. So that ground alone nodi yavaga ellaru bargal bidanta pradesh kondu nodidrandra mannalle enagutte crack bidutte andre enri all the water level water which is present in the water in the soil, so that will be removed off. So that these droughts are caused when there is no rainfall or very little rainfall for a long period of time in the area. So when these droughts occur, so even we have the borewells. So even though if we draw the water from the borewells, so the ground water will be there. For example, see, this is the bedrock will be there. So here some water will be there. If you think, so here this is the upper surface. And here if you have the water pumps, so it can take the water. So if it is no rainfall, so no underground water will be stored. So when the underground water, the level of underground water is increases when the rainfall takes place and when the seepage of water ee mali ada yenagutte nelagalaga neer absorb aagutte adha neerana yenagutte ee water illeno bedrock yenagutte ಅದನ್ನ ನಡು ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಸೋ ಅಲ್ಲೇನ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ವಾಟರ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವೇನ್ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ಅಂಡರ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಪಂಪ್ಸ್. ಸೋ ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ರೇನ್ಫಾಲ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ವಾಟರ್. ಮಳೆನ ಆಗಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀರು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಆಗುದಿಲ್ಲ, ಈ ವಾಟರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ, ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೈತಿ. ನಾವು ಅದೇ ನೀರನ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡ ಅದ್ರ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ, ಆ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗೋದನ್ನ ಹೋಗ್ತೈತಿ. It will become buried and we will not get any water. Even when the droughts occur, we are not able to get the water for drinking purpose also. And it affects the farmers in heavy extent, because the farmers are depending on the crops, and if there is no water, the farmer cannot grow the crops. The crops will become dry, and also the animals will also. They will also not get any livestock, and they will also die, and even many farmers also die. So likewise, this will be very destructive, the droughts. And see, some places will be there. So once the places are green, now they become the means they will become dry. So what is the reason for that? So the rain is caused due to the evaporation of water. And when the plants will be there, so when we plant the trees, they will bring the rain because they absorb the water and the evaporation also takes place, and from the plants the transpiration also takes place. And what we are doing nowadays, we cut the trees for the purpose of the shelter or the furniture and many other purposes, so that when the trees are reduced, so the water, the rainfall also reduced. So when the rainfall is reduced, it may bring the droughts. So this is one reason, and these are the natural disasters. Now we can discuss the role of the government. What are the roles of the government in such disasters? So ee riti ella natural calamities affect aadaga government yav riti adu kelsa maadu. So about that we can discuss now. Role of the government. Role of the government. So the first thing, the government issues forecast and warning. The first thing is it issues forecast and warnings. So meteorological department antare one department irutte government naga. So the function of this meteorological department is to collect the weather report. Weather report na collect madidru. Aa weather report collect madidaga avarge some weather satellites will be there. So those satellites will send the report. So aa report prakara avaru en madtaru calculation madtaru ee place olaga inta time ge, means on the average they will tell, not exactly on that day. Sometimes it will be exact, sometimes it may be altered for some one day like that. So they will give the report to the government and government issues the forecast and warnings. So on this place, on this date, the cyclone will hit or any other disasters may occur, so that the people who are there in that places, they have to move to the safer places. So likewise, they issue the warnings and they forecast. This is one. And government reaches out to save and evacuate victims. So yaar affected agittarla avaru save maadu sambandha en maartaru government avaru on force un kalsutta. So they will save them. And also government opens rehabilitation centers. Yes, the government opens rehabilitation centers. So the people who are affected, so they will be provided with food and water and beds. So whatever the necessary things are there, they are provided with that, the clothes and everything, and even medicines also. And even the government also keep some stock for this. They are called as the buffer stock. ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೈತಿ ಮುಂಚೆನ ಒಂದಿಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ಸ್ ತಂದಿರ್ತೈತಿ, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್, ದ ಫುಡ್, ದ ಕ್ಲೋತ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್, ದ ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ಸ್, ಫುಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್, ವಾಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಬಫರ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್, ಅಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನೀಡೆಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಯಾಚ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ದ ವಿಕ್ಟಿಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರೋಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ದನ್ ದ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್, some other the volunteers and non government organizations are also there. So even they also provide the medicines, clothing and the bed and the work, the necessary things to live. So those all will be provided by these volunteers or the non government organizations also. So this is about the natural calamities and also the role of government. Yes, now I will show you and attach a video clip with this, so that you can understand how these cyclones, floods and droughts are occur. Now we can see that. cyclones. Cyclones are powerful winds that circulate about a center of low atmospheric pressure. These are caused due to creation of low pressure zones over the seas. Cyclones are common in and around Bay of Bengal in the northern Indian Ocean. It can cause heavy rains and strong winds. In the North Indian Ocean, cyclones are more common in the months of April to December. Tropical storms in the northern and southwestern Indian Ocean are called cyclones, and these cyclones, they rotate clockwise. In the Atlantic and northern Pacific Ocean, these cyclones are called hurricanes. And in the northwestern Pacific, they are called typhoons. And these both typhoons and hurricanes rotate anti-clockwise. The Katrina hurricane that struck the northwestern coast of America in August 2005 is one of the four fiercest storms which the US has now. Katrina hurricane had winds moving at a speed of 175 meter per hour. Nearly 2000 people died as cities were flooded, buildings were destroyed, and thousands of residents were forced to flee their homes. Effects of cyclones. The strong surging winds carry water into the land areas, causing damage to life, property, and natural surroundings. So here are the destruction caused by the cyclones. You can see in this picture. These storms can also change the landscape of an area, resulting in hills, roads, and trains being washed away. They lead to tremendous loss of life. Dead bodies lying in the open can cause outbreak of diseases. The victims get cut off from the world for all practical purposes. So they need clothings and food, medicines and drinking water and bedding on daily basis and all they require. Now the floods. Cyclonic floods occur in coastal areas, but many inland areas face floods from overflowing rivers due to heavy rains. The Himalayan River Kosi is called the sorrow of Bihar because every year it overflows and causes floods after heavy rainfall. To prevent floods, we build the dams and interconnected canal systems. So these prevent the floods, and floods are the most common natural disaster in India. Droughts. Droughts are caused when an area receives little or no rainfall for a large period of time. Then it causes the drought. In such places, the earth's surface gets patched and cracked. Lakes, rivers, and streams become dry, and underground water table goes down drastically. So here. So when we pump water from the ground, however, this process is reversed as water seeps from the river to compensate for the loss in groundwater, so that this will cause the droughts even. And droughts have the most adverse effects on farmers. Droughts result in death of cattle and livestock. Droughts cause shortage of drinking water, drying up of crops, and a jump in prices of essential commodities like food items, sugar, etc. Role of the government. The government issues forecasts and warnings. The government reaches out to save and evacuate victims. It opens rehabilitation centers with food, clothing, water, and medicine supplies. The government keeps food grain stocks reserved for such adverse times. And these stocks of food, medicines, and water are also called buffer stocks. Many volunteers and non-government organizations provide emergency medical help and take other rehabilitation measures. So this is about the natural calamities or natural disasters. I hope you have understood this, and even though if you have any queries regarding this, you can contact me and clarify your doubts. Thank you. Have a nice day.